Can somebody walk me through this problem type?
Sure. Here, we are solving this logarithmic equation, and I will show you two ways to do it. First way, we have just one log equal to a number, then we can do the following. So here is a quick note on the side. Whenever we're solving a log equation, log base b, and let's say we have some expression inside, and let's say this is equal to a number, it can be any number. This could be negative, it could be zero, it can be fraction, it can be any number. You have to be careful, because sometimes when you're solving an exponential equation that you use log to solve it, exponential equations cannot end up with a negative number, but that's a topic for another video. So log can equal any number at the end. When you have this, what you do is you do b to this power and you do b to that power. The reason is b is because that's the base for the logarithm. And the deal is that this and that will cancel, and you will just get the inside being equal to b raised to whatever that power is. And then you just continue to do the usual thing because you don't have the log anymore. So here we go. We have log base 3 of this is equal to 12. I'm going to do 3 to this power and do the same thing here so that we can cancel out this and that. And we get 27x to the third power, it's equal to 3 to the 12th power. Now, as you can see, 3 to the 12th power is a pretty big number, so I'm actually not going to work that out because that is actually going to be too much computation. We will be utilizing rule of exponents later on. But anyways, 27 times this is equal to that. I will divide both sides by 27. So they cancel. So x to the third power equals, on the top is 3 to the 12th power. But what's this? 27 is the same as 3 times 3 times 3, which is 3 to the third power. Right? And then what we can do next is we can use the rule of exponents. Another note, when we have, let's say, the note. When we have b to some power, let's say m, divided by b to some power n, this is equal to b raised to the m minus n power. So let's utilize that. You see, you do not have to work this out, but you have to do this. Anyways, we get x to the third power equals 12 minus 3 is 9, so that's 3 to the 9th power. At the end, we are going to solve for x, and this is the third power. So we will take the cube root on both sides. Or you can also look at this side, raise both sides to the 1/3 power. So that when you do this times that, they cancel. When you have a power to a power, you multiply the powers. So that's another note. B to the m, ta raised to the power n, you multiply them. So that's b to the m times n. 3 times 1/3 is just 1, so you can get x to the first power, and then you get 3. 9 times 1/3 is 9 over 3, which is just 3. So you have 3 to the third power. And then 3 to the third power, you work that out again, you get 27. So that's the answer. So here's how we are going to do it if we use the log properties first. Right here, notice that we have log base 3 of 27, and this is a multiplication, 27 times x to the third power. So here are some notes for you. Note that if we have log with some base, let's say b, and let's say we have two things inside, let's say a times b, we can break it down. We will get two logs. The first one is still log base b, but the input is just a. And then you are going to add it with another log, same base, but the input is this capital B. So utilize this property for this part right here. We get log base 3 of 27 plus log base 3 of x to the third power, and that's equal to 12. By the way, let me just mention that whenever you have just a number inside of a log, you don't necessarily need to use the parentheses. But if you have like the exponent or whatnot inside of a log, make sure you use the parentheses. And you can never go wrong if you just put parentheses everywhere to make it super clear, but it's just a style of how you are going to write it. That's why right here, I only put on A without the parentheses. But anyways, notice that this log base 3 of 27, we can get that it's just a number. And to compute logarithm with our calculator, we can do the following. Another property. Log base B, if the input happens to be the same base, B, and let's say we have some power here, M, they cancel. We just get M back. Can we do that right here? Yes, because 27 is the same as 3 to the third power. So look at this as log base 3 of 3 to the third power, right? Because I have two things, that's why I put down the parentheses. But anyways, they cancel, we just get a 3. Right? So this is just 3. Now we have this. What can we do next though? We cannot cancel because the base here is not the same as this base. What we can do is, we can put the power to the front. That's another property. When we have log with some base B, if the base are not the same, let's say we have some A, right, just like that A, let's say A, to some power M, we can put the power to the front. So that becomes M times log base B of A. If the A is also little b, right, if this A is the same as that, then they cancel, you just get 1. So they are pretty much the same thing. If, 剪掉这边. And in fact, if capital A is the same as little b, they cancel, you just get 1. So you get this property here. But anyways, I'll put the 3 to the front. And then we have log base 3 of x, and that's equal to 12. Now, solving this equation, I'll just minus 3 to both sides, cancel, and then we get 3 log base 3 of x, it's equal to 9. This is 3 times this part, right? So I'll just divide both sides by 3, cancel. So log base 3 of x, it's equal to 3. Now finally, this is what we did earlier, right? Whenever we have log of a base of something is equal to a number, we do the same base here, so 3 to this power, and then we do 3 to that power. This way, this and that cancel, so we just get x equals 3 to the third power, which is 27. Yep, just like that.